Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. This is Red Race Rider. I'm your host. How y'all doing today? Alright, we're gonna give this another shot. Lost Trail Coffee did sponsor this series. Their link is in the description down below. There's also a code there for you to get 10% off your purchase, so please go check it out. Silver. Now we can make that other trinket we got. Alright, we really only wanted to kill those guys because we're gonna go down here. We're gonna take out this ambush jackass bastard. And if you guys don't like the way I do my videos, I post too much, or I should talk more or something like that, let me know in the comments. Nice. Intense. I want the views. I'd like to make this a full-time job at some point, but I don't have that ability right now. Seriously, this guy hits so damn hard, it's not even funny. He's hitting almost boss level hard. We're just gonna skip all the mobs up to that guy. We're gonna focus on killing him because I'm kind of tired of dying. This wouldn't be a problem if I lowered difficulty, but I'd like to beat the game on this difficulty, so we're gonna keep it with that. I mean, so far this isn't a bad game. The next game we're doing, it comes out on the 18th. It is Plague Requiem. It is the second game in that series. I liked the first one. I played it before I was a YouTuber, before I started making content on YouTube. We're gonna go check it out. Maybe it looks like it'll be a fun game. It's a stealth game, so that'll be a lot of fun. Oh no! And I died. Yay. I hate the fact that I hate the fact that I die so often. Like, I try so hard not to die that often so I can give you guys half decent content, but I mean, if I didn't play it on the hardest difficulty, then what's the point? least they give us things they give relatively good. They give good crafting material. I thought my cam was a little quiet. My volume was at like 68. That I can't see shit. Good job. You fucking smokescreened the whole room and decided to ambush me. Not to mention, the game won't let me lock onto him. Even though you can clearly see him, you can't lock onto him no matter what. Because he's technically an ambush. So, I think we're just gonna lure that guy outside. He's gonna drop the smoke bombs. I'm gonna run back outside the wall and let him come to me so I can actually lock on and kick his ass, because trying to work my camera and the attack buttons and dodge all at the same time is a little bit of a pain in the ass on a controller. Did I send that far elevator back up? I didn't. God damn it. I didn't think that was gonna work. Alright, my only choice is to be him. That's fucking lame.
You causing trouble in the mine.
Whoa! It's been, what, 2 years? I didn't even recognize you. Oh, and hey, call me Slightly. I get nervous when people use my real name.
I'm okay with you being nervous. What the hell just happened?
Is this gonna affect the bounty on my head?
Quit being a smartass, Shay. Just answer me.
All right. I threw the smoke grenades to stop those guys from trying to kill me. Not at you, all right?
Who wants to kill you?
Listen, I know you really want to arrest me. I get it, really. But first, I gotta tell you what's going on in the mine. Just listen, please.
You're in no position to be bargaining with me.
But I'm so good at it. Look, a warrior of the Northwind Legion wouldn't be around these parts for no reason. The more information, the better, right?
Smartass.
Why are the goblins back in Aphes? Tired of the Northwind Legion cleaning up after your antics?
Please, stop calling what we do antics. It hurts my feelings. The king forces us to give tribute, which is what got him cursed in the first place, but we're more than willing to take up the responsibility.
Responsibility for what?
To return to Aphes and help the king lift the curse.
Oh, I didn't know that the notorious goblins were so kind-hearted.
Hey, there's a lot that you don't know. My boss, Old Whitebrow, believes that the way to remove the curse is in the mine. We've made a lot of new discoveries here.
Alright, let's just say that I believe your lies for just a second. You're still a criminal in the eyes of the law. I can't ignore that.
Oh my god, Wildy.
Of course. I'm well aware of that. But that's the law of the Embari, which doesn't apply here. What's more, now's probably not the best time to arrest me.
Where are the others? And where's your boss, this old Whitebrow?
Don't look at me like that. They aren't off pillaging valuables, for now at least. Things have gotten a bit awkward, you see. They're the ones trying to kill me.
What do you mean?
We ventured even deeper into the mine than last time. Old Whitebrow was pretty excited. But after a couple of days, there was a terrifying roar from within the pit. The whole ground shook. Then we heard a strange voice, and, well, they haven't been themselves since. They either went completely blank and expressionless, or they just started attacking each other. It was terrifying, seeing one's comrades turn to strangers before your very eyes, in that dark, narrow cavern.
So you ran away.
So I ran away. And then I mistook you for one of the ones chasing me.
You're all idiots. You have no idea what you've gotten yourself into.
Alright, spare me the yapping. You think you know this place better than we do?
I know better than to barge in like you did. Also, don't act tough when you're at the tip of someone's blade. It's not a good look. So what now?
Oh, let's go. Come on.
Come rescue Old Whitebrow with me? I don't care about the others, but I can't leave Old Whitebrow behind. I have to save him. And I don't trust the other goblins waiting outside the village for, various reasons. So, I don't want to send a distress call.
You goblins are always trouble.
Don't say that. Please, help me. I'm risking my life here begging you.
You want us to work together? Are you serious?
Oh no, not work together. I'm requesting, nay, beseeching a great, powerful, and wise warrior of the Northwind Legion to help me with a small task.
Oh my god.
Do you plan to capture me and take me back? Or maybe tie me up here and face those insane goblins by yourself?
Shut up. No matter what I do, you'll still find a way to go back and save Old Whitebrow, right?
Hey, great minds think alike, am I right?
Give me your weapon. I'd rather go into the mine with you than let you go running off by yourself. But if you try anything funny, I'll end you right there on the spot.
Sounds like a bad deal for me. Whatever, it's better than fighting by myself in the mine. I'll follow you closely, and I promise to behave myself.
Let's go then.
Dude, this whole
so
conversation
excited.
Sounded like
Slightly
a lover's quarrel.
Legion warrior united again.
Shut it.
Seriously, that entire thing sounded like a lover's quarrel. Like, why are you here? What are you doing? Are you stupid? You dumbass. Like, it's straight up, like, 100% lover's quarrel. Can I make that jump? Nope. And I duck. I swear to Bejesus Almighty. This is annoying. Now I have to run all the fucking way back down there. I'm starting to think I should have gone to the Fallon Academy instead. Damn. This is stupid annoying, man. ride the slowest elevators in the world. Of course, I just happened to go the wrong way, which is why we died.
Here I go. Whee!
I think they'll just leave us alone if we just ignore them.
Huh. Looks like it's busted. No, I have an idea. I'll go ahead. Just wait.
Hey, don't go! You...
Stop calling me. Whatever. You thought I was gonna run off? Don't worry. I still need you to find old Whitebrow. I know you don't trust me, so I'll say it again. I promise to behave myself.
Yeah. Let's keep going.
Wait. Look at these markings on the wall. I didn't see these when I left the pit.
What do they mean?
Old Whitebrow marked safe passages while mapping out the mine. These marks are brand new, though. But something isn't right. We used it all the time, and it was always safe.
If he always passed through here, there would be no need to mark it recently.
Right. There's only two possibilities. Either the paths in the mine are changing, or he's gone bonkers. I hope that it's the former. If the pit's alive, then the anomalies would kind of make sense.
There is a third possibility. That you're lying to me.
Oh, I wouldn't do that. If I'm lying, I'll tell you, all right?
Lover's quarrel.
Let's keep going.
You should scout ahead first. We set up camp in an abandoned smelter. Watch for traps when you check it out.
What the? What the fuck is this thing? Oh, how am I gonna not stop falling for that? Oh my god. Come on, let me check it. Oh, okay. Oh. Seriously. Oh my god! I have to stop locking on to shit. Every time I lock on to something, it doesn't let me change directions. Like, the lock on in this game is busted. Well, we checked out one way. Let's check out the other. From this moment on, Legion soldiers originally stationed within the mine must withdraw from the front line and defend only the mine's perimeter and the pit village entrance. All unauthorized personnel must be prevented from entering or leaving the mine with no exceptions. Archon, Legion of Marlboro. Seriously.
Ah.
Oh, no healings. Yay. And I die. Alright, well, we're gonna end it on that episode, on that, everybody. That's 28 minutes. It's gonna be the last episode for tonight. I posted 12 yesterday, so we're going to only post 4 today, and I will post more tomorrow morning. I will catch you all in the next episode of Asteriogos Curse of the Stars. Keep your eyes open. Don't forget to turn on your notifications. Please hit that like and subscribe button. It does help out a lot. I'd like to make this full-time job, so yeah, I'll catch you guys in the next episode. This is Red Rays Rider, signing off.